Hello and welcome to the Boon Guide to Linux Reloaded. In this video series, I'm going to guide you to the world of Linux on your desktop PC or notebook. I will show you how to install Linux alongside any existing operating systems, how to set it up as a daily driver, and how to use it from the very beginning till advanced use. You may have already noticed a part number on the video title, like 1.0. The primary number marks a chapter, and the secondary number marks any sort of specialization around that topic. Watching all parts of a chapter is not required to get started with Linux and to use it on a daily basis. The minor numbers are only to get a bit more detailed about a topic and also to get more advanced. The higher the secondary number is, the more technical and detailed the video will be, and also the required skill level is higher. I try to indicate the required skill level in the video description as follows. Baby Penguin? Very basic stuff everybody should be able to understand and follow. It's for the not that tech-savvy people among you. Teenage Penguin? Is a little bit more advanced, but not that difficult after all. With basic computer knowledge, you should be able to follow those videos just with ease. Some terminal commands might appear here and there, but nothing a degree in shell scripting would be required for. Adult Penguin? Those videos are, of course, more advanced. If you don't fear to work with a terminal, you should have no issues to follow those videos. Elder Penguin? Parts with this skill level might be very rare, but will require some more solid and advanced under-the-hood Linux knowledge, like advanced shell scripting, but still I try to keep those parts as accessible as possible for new users. You may ask why the series is called Reloaded. This is because I already did the Boon Guide to Linux, but that one was only in German and also focused on a different version of Linux. This series will focus on another version of Linux, and also it will be available in both languages, German and English. This, however, does not mean that the distribution used in this series is a must-have requirement to start your Linux journey. In my eyes, it just makes a few things a lot easier to set up and tweak to our needs. You need to think of Linux distribution as a set of pre-configured applications and settings, but you can make any distribution to fit your needs. Some distros just do make this process easier than others. Since this channel is mainly focused on Linux and gaming, this series is also aimed at setting up a Linux for gaming. But I will also cover other areas like technical painting, 3D animations, office, programming, scripting, installing drivers, compiling software from source, and multimedia stuff and other things which are required to run any Linux distribution on a daily basis. I hope you enjoy the series and you'll learn a lot about Linux and hopefully stay with us penguins. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Have a nice day.